soft tissue, types of injuries. All right, so again, we're gonna talk about labrums, right? We can talk about rotator cuffs, right? Rotator cuff. And soft tissue injuries would be, I'm gonna put Hill-Sachs again, because Hill-Sachs is a dislocation fracture. Okay, Bankart, and a bony one. There's two types. One is just soft tissue, one is a soft tissue plus fracture. Then you have your slap lesions, and then here you have your tears, right? You can have, it's trauma or it's chronic. The other one really here is like capsule types of issues, but this is more like your multi-directional instability people, right? So this kind of goes in play with labrums, but it almost gets its own little thing. But really, you want to start thinking about your soft tissue injuries, and I'm just breaking them up, right? I'm just breaking them up. You're going to have people who have both. It's just like when you're looking at a hand and it's got like a fracture and a flexor tendon, what do you do first? What do you do second? Same thing here on the shoulder, right? You have a bony thing, you have a soft tissue thing, which one is worse for them, right? And then you're going to be careful with the thing that's worse for them, because you can't mess it up. If a bone's unstable, who cares what happened to the tendon? You can't move it because the bone's unstable, right? But if the bone is stable, now we can worry about the soft tissue. All right, so is it chronic? Is it trauma? So the trauma, so chronic versus trauma. Shit, sometimes it's both. Damn these people. If only there was an A and B and not an A, B, C, and D, right? But really, you have your traumas. They can be dislocations, they can be fracture dislocations, they can be congenital, right? Now, shoulder is very much based on what you do and stuff like that, and these type of injuries can be based on age as well. So don't forget, on the test question, when they're talking about age, what you know, you have to think about that. And I think about that every single time I get a patient that comes in with a shoulder problem, you know? I think of them, are they loosey-goosey or stiff as a board people? I kind of break my people into two types of people. Or my shoulder people, I'm like, are you a loosey-goosey type of person? I look at their shoulder, I look at their elbow, and I look at their fingers to see, you know, are they a loosey-goosey kind of person or are they stiff as a board, right? But I also look at age, you know? People who are coming into you in their 40s, 50s, 60s, stuff like that, you treat them in one way. Someone who's in their 30s, 20s, teens, you might treat these soft tissue types of issues in a different way, along with bony stuff, you know? So don't forget that part. Don't tell yourself, you know, funny stories on the test, but look at the question at hand. Listen to only the story it tells you. But if they have age in there, usually I always say the age is there for a reason. Just think about it. Might not change your answer or whatever, but just have a consideration, you know, about age, because someone who's younger will tend to have more of an instability that's chronic, that's due to capsular types of issues, multi-directional instability types of issues, than someone who's older, right? They might still have those things, but they're older. Damn them. All right, so let's take a look at soft tissue types of injuries and look at the directional stuff. So I think I drew this out, so let me see if I draw this out. So I got my little glenoid, right? My little glenoid. And when we're talking about capsules and all that good stuff, and we're talking about labrum types of issues, and we're talking about capsules, this plays a role, right? This oval. So you have your superior, your inferior, your anterior, and your posterior, right? Superior, inferior, anterior, posterior. I'm looking at the right shoulder. All right, you can draw it from the left shoulder. Really, it's okay too. But really, you're gonna be looking at, no, you never want the head of the humerus to go superior. Because guess what's on top? You know, guess what's on top? The acromion, right? So you never wanted that humeral head to keep going upwards, but this is a superior. Most of the time you want the humeral head to go inferior to the back and to the front, right? So here's where some of your issues are gonna be, right? So if you have a labrum type of issue, you could have a Bankart type of issue where it's an anterior-posterior problem or anterior-inferior problem or posterior-inferior problem is a Bankart type of lesion, right? And then you can have a slap, right? So the slap is already telling you superior labrum from anterior to posterior tear. All right. So it affects the biceps, right? Because the biceps inserts right here. So now when you're talking about protocols and things like that, you're just taking your applied anatomy, biomechanics, kinematics types of things, and you're applying it. So if you think about how the humeral head moves, you know, if you're working with a slap lesion, you don't want anything that's going to, if they go and they sew this up and they anchor that biceps, usually they take the long head of the biceps and they'll anchor it down to another part, right? So the biceps can move and stuff like that, but they need to not irritate it, right? But if they go ahead and they fix it and they leave the biceps there, if they fix that, can you mess with it? Right? You don't want to mess with it. So with the slap lesion, you're kind of looking to avoid strain of the biceps, right? For 0 to 6 weeks, you're trying to avoid strain of the biceps. So what are you not allowed to do? Because what does the bicep do? Well, first of all, shouldn't be doing a ton of bicep curls, right? You're not going to be carrying things with your arm extended because that's going to be pulling on the biceps. Bicep plays a role and it gets stressed out when the shoulder goes into end range external rotation. End range external rotation, right? So it strains the biceps when it does that. You can't go into shoulder extension because it's going to strain the biceps. So you think through your motion and say, okay, well, if it's a slap and I don't want to stress this top part of my labrum, which is attached to my biceps, what do I need to do to stop messing with my biceps, right? So let's avoid putting your shoulder into shoulder extension, doing shoulder internal rotation behind the back, right? Because that's going to stress the biceps. Carrying with the elbow extended, doing any kind of end range external rotation with 90 degrees of abduction. So in the first 0 to 6 weeks, you don't want to do that. But then after 6 weeks, you can start going into more active motion without any limitations. And then from there, the third phase is then strengthening. So soft tissue is kind of broken into three phases, right? So what is it? Did I write that down? Oh yeah. So it's into three phases, 0 to 6 weeks, 6 to 12 weeks. And then 12 to 24 weeks, right? So the first 0 to 4 weeks can vary depending on your surgeon and stuff like that. But basically the rule of thumb is you can either start with immobilization, no motion at all, or you can start with some passive range of motion. And about 4 to 6 weeks, you can start moving more. Or greater than 4 weeks, you start light PREs. You should have full motion by then. And then here, your full-blown PREs, right? So it's kind of, 0 to 4, 4 to 6, right? So start active, light, PREs, right? The light is just the weight of your arm type of thing. It's either no motion or passive range of motion. And then here, this is where you're gaining, increase all your active range of motion, start strengthening, right? And then here on the last phase, you're sports specific. So you're starting to do more dynamic types of stuff, right? That's usually what, that's 3 months out. 3 months out doing closed chain stuff, weight bearing, neuromuscular control, plyometrics type of stuff, right?
Hey therapy friends, it's Hwang here. Thanks again for watching my video. And if you like videos like this that can help you just crush it in the hand therapy world as an occupational therapist, then hit the subscribe button and enjoy the video. Thanks again for watching.